Okay, continuing further with question number 6 of exercise 10.3 of your textbook. Okay, a tabletop measures 2 meter by 1 meter 50 centimeter. What is its area in square meters? Tabletop means the top surface of the table like this, right? This is called a tabletop. Okay, now here length is 2 meters, but what about breadth? Breadth is 1 meter 50 centimeter. Centimeter generally have 2 digits, so here we need not need to convert, only you can write directly with the decimal point. So we have to find out the answer in square meters. So 1.50, as we have kept decimal, so we have converted this into meters. So 1.50 meters. I had not shown the conversion because here in centimeter we have 2 digits and we require 2 digits. So directly 1.50 meters. Rest you know, area of rectangle L into B, so 2 meter length into 1.5 meter or 1.50 meter breadth. Answer is 3 square meter. 7 is your homework. Now question number 8. A floor is 5 meter long and 4 meter wide. So rectangular floor is 5 meter length and 4 meter broad breadth. A square carpet of side 3 meter is laid on the floor. Find the area of the floor that is not carpeted. Okay, now we have a rectangular floor and we just spread a carpet on the floor. So, but obvious it is not on the boundaries, it is inside the rectangular floor, right? It covers the whole area where it is spread. So, first of all, we will find out the area of rectangle. So, here formula of area will be applicable because carpet we have inside the floor and it covers that much portion. So, area. So, L into B for rectangular floor is 20 square meter. And again for the square carpet, area we have to find. So, area of square carpet is L into L, 3 into 3, that is 9 square meter. But now we want that after having the carpet in the floor, how much area is left uncovered with carpet. So what we will do? Find area of the floor not carpeted. So the area left over where the carpet is not occupying the space or it's not spread over there. So area of rectangular floor minus area of carpet spread where we have kept. So 20 square meter is of floor area and 20 square meter is the area of floor and 9 square meter is the area of square carpet where we have spread that. So 20 minus 9 will be your 11 square meter is the area where the carpet is not lying or it is uncarpeted area, we can see. Okay, question number 9. 5 flower beds, square flower beds, each of side 1 meter are dug on a piece of land 5 meter long and 4 meter wide. What is the area of the remaining part of the land? Now here, land is in a rectangular form where L and B is given. So, flower beds are the area where we grow the flowers, right? They are the in the rows. So here they are in the square shaped where we can grow, but the land which is given is in a rectangular form. So find out area of land, rectangular land, that is 20 square meter. Now here square flower bed with length is given, its side is 1 meter. So first of all what we will do, we will find out the area of square flower bed. So L into L, 1 meter into 1 meter means 1 square meter. Okay, for 1 flower bed, we have 1 square meter area. So we have how many such flower beds given here? 5. So 5 into 1 is equal to 5 square meter. Again, we have to find out the area where the flower beds are not covering that part of land. So, area of remaining part of land where flower beds are not kept or not been made there. So, area of rectangular land minus area of square flower bed. So, 20 square meter is the area of rectangular land minus 5 square meter is the area of flower bed, square flower bed, minus 20 minus 5. So your answer is 15 square meter where the land is as it is which do not have flower bed in it. Thank you for today.